If you own a Sinden light gun and want to get up and running quickly with a Raspberry Pi, then the best way to do that is to use Barebones, which is the only publicly available image made by Sinden light gun users for Sinden light gun users. It's free and available for download from sindenwiki.org, and support for it is available from the Sinden light gun Discord community. Now, Barebones 9 was made with the expectation that the majority of users will be using TVs or monitors in the now standard 16:9 aspect ratio, but there are still many users who want to use a smaller screen in the traditional 4:3 aspect ratio, or even in some cases 5:4. Yeah, I'm not kidding, for some reason Arcade 1UP produced a whole bunch of arcade style cabinets with obscure 5:4 screens, and nobody knows why. But the problem exists that these narrower screens will compress the 16:9 picture into the smaller space, and it doesn't look good, as you can see. But there's an easy solution. Hi there, and welcome to this tutorial on how to quickly and easily convert the Barebones 9 image for Raspberry Pi for use on a 4:3 or 5:4 aspect ratio screen. So here you can see that I have Barebones loaded up to the main menu screen. I'm using a 4:3 monitor, and as you can see, the picture looks a bit squashed and distorted because it's trying to display widescreen 16:9 images on this narrower screen. So here's how we can fix that quickly. But before we go any further, I should advise you that it'd be wise to make a backup of your image before you proceed. Although this utility has been thoroughly tested, it's always possible that there's something unaccounted for that can mess up your system. So please make a backup, particularly if you've invested a lot of time and effort into your image already. And I'll also add a little disclaimer that the utility that I'm about to show you has been made exclusively for Barebones. You could try to use it on some other third-party image, but it's not guaranteed to work on anything other than Barebones. It might partly work, or it might just balk your system completely. So I wouldn't recommend using it on anything other than Barebones, but if you choose to do so, you do so at your own risk. Anyway, let's get into it. So I've got a keyboard connected to my Pi, and my Pi is connected to the internet with an Ethernet cable. You can use Wi-Fi if you know how to set that up on your Pi, but I'm not going to get into that in this video. Okay, so if I press F4 on my keyboard, we instantly leave the menu and end up at the Raspberry Pi command line interface. Now, we need to download and run a script which is available from my GitHub repository. I strongly recommend that you read the README file on that repo beforehand, so I'll put a link to that in the description. The first thing we're told to do on the instructions that are in the repo is to remove any earlier versions of the script, if we've used it before. If you've never done this before, then you probably don't need to worry about this step, but it's probably worth checking just to be on the safe side. Now, we're already in the home directory for the Pi user. I'll just type ls to list what's in the directory. And as you can see, the first file on the list is called bb_screenratio.sh. And that is the utility we need to use, but I don't know if this is the latest version because it's been on this machine quite a while. So I need to delete it first. So I'll just type rm bb_screenratio.sh. That seemed to have worked. I'll press ls again just to check, and it's no longer there. That's brilliant. Now we need to type a wget command followed by the address of the file that's on my GitHub that we need to download. I'm not going to read it out to you because that would just be boring, but I'll tell you that if you look on the repo, it's written clearly on there, and I'll also put it down in the description below. But make sure you check out that repo. And here it is. That's the file we need. Pay careful attention to where the capital letters are. It's important that you do put correct casing whenever you're dealing with files on a Raspberry Pi or any other Linux system, to be honest. Okay, let's hit enter. And there we go. Yep, it looks like that downloaded okay. Let's just press ls again to confirm that it's there. And as you can see, yep, it's the first one on the list. Now you might see there that it's white instead of green. That means that it's just a normal file. It isn't executable. So we need to give it executable permission, and we do that now by typing chmod space plus x followed by the file name, which is bb underscore screenratio.sh. Press enter, that looks good. Let's ls again. And as you can see, it is now green. And that means it's executable and we can run it like any other command. Now, in order to run this, we need to do it with root or admin privileges. And we do that by typing sudo, S-U-D-O, space before the command. And then we type the path in the file name, which is .bb_screenratio.sh. Now, the .slash means that the file that we want to run can be found in the current directory. .slash is the current directory. It's important to specify the location of the file that you want to run whenever you run a command. So that is the command we need to run, and I'm going to press enter, and we're in the menus. Okay, so here's the first screen. It's a warning that we need to have an internet connection, which clearly we have because we just downloaded this file. And it's asking us if we're sure that we want to proceed. You can use the keyboard arrow keys and the enter key to make your selection. Now we're being asked what screen ratio we want to use. So in my case, I'm looking at a 4:3 ratio monitor. So I'm going to choose option number 2, which is 4:3 classic. And as you can see, it's just making a couple of changes very quickly. And then it'll ask the next question about how we want to treat certain games that you might still want to have a 16:9 ratio for. In this case, the arcade games Golly Ghost and Bubble Trouble have a scoreboard that utilize the sides of a 16:9 display. Now I'm going to choose to remove the scoreboard so that the game fills the screen, but you could also choose to keep the scoreboard and have that game letterbox to make it fit on your screen. But I'm going to press yes to remove it. And now the next question asks me how I want to treat some games that are narrower than a 4:3 ratio. So many arcade games use a 4:3 monitor that was rotated 90 degrees, effectively making it a 3:4 ratio instead. Do I want to use the correct ratio and pillarbox the game on my screen? Or do I want to stretch it out to fill the screen? Now I firmly believe in not distorting games whenever possible. So I'm going to choose option 1, correct ratio. But if you're one of those people that likes to stretch games out to fill your screen, then you have the option to do so. And now here are some more similar questions for outlying games with unusual ratios. I'm just going to choose correct ratio for all of these. There we go. And here it's made the change already. The only thing left to do is reboot. So here we go. Now, that was really quick. The part of this that takes the longest is the rebooting. It really, really only takes like less than a minute to go through this process. And it's a lot quicker than doing it manually. Now, while it's rebooting, I just want to take a moment to ask you, if you found this video to be helpful, please hit the like button and please subscribe. It would mean a lot to me if you would consider to do so. And feel free to write a comment. And now, as you can see, we're reloading Barebones, and it already looks really good. It's shaped and sized correctly for the screen that I'm using. The big giveaway here is the circle of the target in the Sinden logo. That is actually round. Circles always need to be round. If you're ever looking at a display and you see circles that aren't round, then that means usually that your display is in the wrong aspect ratio. But this is proof here that we are looking at a screen that's correctly proportioned for the display we're using. And just to back that up, I'm just going to quickly load again to show you what it looks like now. This is Gangster Town. And while that's loading, the last thing I just want to tell you is that if you do change your mind, maybe later on down the line, you change your TV to a widescreen one, and you want to keep this image, but you want to restore the 16:9 ratio and all the config files and bezels that make it pretty, just run the utility again. And when you choose the ratio, choose 16:9, and then you'll be given the option to download and reinstall the bare bones configs. And once you do that, it just takes a minute, it'll all be back to normal. So it can be undone. And that's all. That's all I have to say. So thank you for watching. I really hope you found this useful. If you do have any questions, then leave a comment if you like, or why not come and visit the Sinden Discord and we'll help you out. I'll leave a link to that down below. But that's all I have for you today. And until next time, happy gaming.